In this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make stuff bouncy. If you've ever dropped stuff in your game, you've probably noticed how unrealistic it is for it to just hit the ground and come to a complete stop. In real life, most falling objects will bounce at least a little bit when hitting the ground or another object, and sometimes what the object hits could impact whether it bounces more or less than usual, such as a trampoline. To accomplish all of this, we'll be using the physics material built into Unity. To make a physics material, I'm going to go down to my assets folder, right click, create a physics material, and I'm going to call it SodaCan, since this is going to be the physics material for the soda cans that I've got. And then in the top right, you'll notice we have five different settings to play around with. So not only is this just for if something is bouncy, but it's also for friction. So dynamic friction is whenever something is sliding across a surface, how much friction is present. And then static friction is whenever it's sitting still, how much friction there is. And typically, if something's sitting still, it actually has a tiny bit more friction than whenever it's moving, because it takes a little bit more force to make something start moving than it does to keep it moving once it's going. So typically, your static friction will either be the same or higher than your dynamic friction. We've also got our bounciness setting, and then all three of these are going to be a value between 0 and 1. For my soda can, I'm going to set this to 0.7. And then we also have friction combine and bounce combine. So let's say if we put our bouncy balls at 1 and our soda cans are at 0.7 for the bounciness, then when they bounce off of each other, they're actually not going to bounce with the exact amount of bounciness that they have in their own setting, because they're bouncing off of a different object that is also bouncy. So if you think in real life, if you were to bounce a soda can off of a very bouncy ball, the soda can's going to bounce a lot more than it normally would because the bouncy ball is so bouncy. So that's what we're doing here, is when two objects that are bouncy are combined, how much bounce ends up coming out of that collision. So typically we'll just take the average value. So if the soda can is at 0.7 and the bouncy ball is at 1, it'll just take whatever the average is between those two numbers, and that'll be the resulting bounce. But you have other settings in here where you could take the minimum value, which would be the soda can in this case. You could multiply those values by each other, or you could just take the maximum value. And then it's pretty much the same thing with friction combined. You have all the same options. Two objects with friction, how are they going to interact with each other? Are you going to just take the average friction between the two, minimum, maximum? So it's really up to you to decide on how your stuff should be behaving. So now to apply this physics material to my soda can, I'm going to go into my prefabs where I have the soda can, open that up, and on the soda can I have a box collider to allow it to hit other objects and collide with other stuff, and one of those settings is a physics material, so I can go into my materials, drag the soda can physics material into there, and now this is going to apply to all of the cans in my scene since I'm changing the parent prefab object. And then both the can and the ball also have a rigid body component, so they're affected by gravity. They're going to fall and be affected by physics. So now going back to my scene, whenever I hit play, you'll see the cans don't just fall flat. They actually have a little bit of a bounce to them, especially this one here on the left. I'll do that one more time, and you'll notice a tiny bit of a bounce there. Looks a little bit more realistic than just falling flat like it was at the beginning. Now to do the same thing with the bouncy ball, I'm going to again create another physics material, and I'm going to just call this bouncy ball. And then here I'm going to go in and say bounciness is 1, leave the other settings, and go back to my prefabs, open up the ball, and drag that material onto the sphere collider on the ball. Going back into the scene and hit play, and you'll see these balls bounce quite a bit more than they did previously, so it's working the way we intend for it to. So next I've gone in here and done something a little bit for fun. I've doubled the amount of cans and balls in the scene, and whenever I hit play, there's actually an interesting thing back here with these two balls being perfectly over top of each other. So this one will stay on the ground, and this other one is getting a lot of bounce back. So you can see this is what's happening whenever two objects with one bounciness on their physics material colliding with each other. There's a lot more bounce than if this ball was just bouncing on the ground. You see how all the rest of them have already stopped bouncing, but these two colliding with each other is resulting in a much bigger bounce happening. So I'm going to show you one last example. This one's kind of like a trampoline, is I've gone to my floor and I've added the bouncy ball Physic material to it just to make it very bouncy. Lastly, I've also made two producers that are going to infinitely spawn the cans and the balls into the scene. So I'm going to just have a bunch of those just raining down onto this trampoline, and they're going to be bouncing all over the place. So let's see how it goes. And that's how you make your objects bouncy in Unity. Thanks for watching, and make sure you subscribe to catch all my latest game development content and tutorials. I'm Reedster with Far Gaming, and I'll catch you on the next one.